while you've understood that you have some power, the way you exercise it should also be restrained. You know, it's a two-way process. If you need me to respect your rights, you must also show me that you have the duty to respect mine. And Ugandans have been on the fence of these two very different things. And we've seen them exercise that power in excesses on two diplomatic spaces, both of the US Embassy in Uganda and the German Embassy in Uganda, in which they've forced some of these platforms to delete tweets that were meant in good, you know, intention. And there are far-reaching implications for that in terms of relations between country A, Germany, or Uganda, or the United States. So Ugandans might not know the implication of that kind of antipathy, but it does exist for governments. It can even, you saw in Kenya, for instance, the Kenyans were on Kenyans on Twitter, actively calling out the IMF not to lend Kenya money. And the IMF did not lend Kenya money, you know. So if you understand that power, it comes with a responsibility. So if you use it to check your government on areas that need to be checked, corruption, freedom of speech, gender issues, climate change, that is rightful use of power. But if you use it to again extend what would be dictatorship kind of views, or to use it to abuse people, to racially abuse, segregate people, to have actual fights, not views of conversations with people with whom you have different political affiliations. Now that is the negative use of these platforms, and that needs to be checked either legally in forms of law or just civic education. Citizens know what is expected of them.